Comparing my times at the end of the day of a demo ride between a Mach 5.5 and a 429 trail, I found that my times down the Nelson Loop were within a second of each other. I put this video together just to show how the bikes compared heading down the loop. They were very comparable.
Hey! This bike feels a little more bouncy than mine. Mine stays on the ground a lot more. This seems to like to launch. Also, I've run out of gearing. So, I would be running this with a 4D11 on my bike, but this one tops out at a 3011, which frankly is just not big enough.
The Mach 5.5 would have beaten the 429 trail by more time had I not slowed up for a rider at the very end of the run. However, at the beginning, the two bikes were neck and neck as they descended down the first part of the descent. Surprisingly, the 5.5 actually gained its advantage on the slight uphill before we continued with the descent down the trail. The limiting factor I found with the 5.5 in terms of its top speed was that the bike came with a 1x11 transmission and its 30x11 top gear just wasn't big enough for me to spin the bike faster. Descending down this trail, I pretty much topped out at about 25 miles an hour. The bike could have gone much faster though.
I want more gears! I've run out of gears! For the big plus tyres coming out of these little gullies, I'd say the bike accelerates pretty well. Oh, thank you, have a good one. Well, something was pinging there. That was the Nelson Loop.